क्लास 11 सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स, सिक्स्थ चैप्टर मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड्स। मैकेनिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉलिड्स, फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर लेट अस सी स्ट्रेन एनर्जी। स्ट्रेन एनर्जी, द इलास्टिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी गेन्ड बाय ए वायर ड्यूरिंग इट्स इलोंगेशन और एक्सटेंशन बाय ए स्ट्रेचिंग फोर्स इज कॉल्ड एज स्ट्रेन एनर्जी। द इलास्टिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी गेन्ड बाय ए वायर ड्यूरिंग इट्स इलोंगेशन और एक्सटेंशन ड्यू टू ए स्ट्रेचिंग फोर्स इज कॉल्ड एज स्ट्रेन एनर्जी। दैट मीन्स व्हेन ए स्ट्रेचिंग फोर्स इज अप्लाइड एट वन एंड ऑफ द वायर देन दैट वायर विल गेट elongated or extended. As that wire is stretched, the work will be done on that wire. That work done will be stored in the form of elastic potential energy, and that elastic potential energy is called as strain energy. That means if any wire of original length capital L is taken, one end of that wire is connected to the rigid support and at the free end of the wire a load F, that is the force F, is applied. Due to this applied force there will be extension or elongation of the wire, that is small l. Now if area of cross section of this wire is equal to A, then let us consider some of the terms in order to obtain the expression for strain energy. So let capital L represents original length of the wire. So in this diagram, capital L is the original length of the wire, that is before stretching that wire its length is equal to L. A is area of cross section of the wire. A is area of cross section, that is area of one of the ends of that wire will be equal to A. Then F is the force acting along the length of the wire. F is the force acting along the length of the wire, that is the stretching force, or it will be called as load. Then due to this stretching force, let L be the elongation, that is extension produced in that wire. So small l will represent the extension or elongation produced in that wire. Now we know that the stress and strain will now increase proportionately when that wire is loaded, and therefore as there is extension or elongation of the wire due to the stretching force, therefore we can define longitudinal stress as force per unit area, that is F by A. Similarly, due to the extension, longitudinal strain will be equal to change in length per unit original length, that is small l upon capital L. Now from this, Young's modulus of material of wire Y, Young's modulus of material of wire Y will be equal to the ratio of longitudinal stress to the longitudinal strain. Longitudinal stress upon longitudinal strain, that will be equal to F upon A upon L upon L. So rearranging the terms, we can write FL upon AL, FL upon AL. This will be formula for Young's modulus Y, and from this formula the stretching force, that is load, F will be equal to YAL upon L. YAL upon L, equation number 1. This equation will represent the load applied at the lower end of that wire, that will be nothing but the stretching force. Now that force will be increased from 0 to F. From 0 to capital F, that will be the limiting value of the force. But this force will be increased in the steps. Suddenly that force will not be increased from 0 to F, but it will be increased step by step. That is, the magnitude of the stretching force increases from 0 to F during the extension of the wire, and as that force is increased step by step at a certain stage, let small f represents the force applied, that is the stretching force, and x be the corresponding extension. So during loading of this wire at any certain stage, if small f represents the stretching force and x represents extension due to that force, then the force acting on the wire at this stage will be given as, so the force for extension x will be given as F is equal to YAX upon L. So from this formula, this L will be replaced by only X, and therefore this small f will be equal to YAX upon L. This will be the force which is acting at that certain stage. And therefore, as that force F is acting on the wire, for further very very small extension dx of that wire, due to this force, work will be done. Now that small work done, dw, will be due to this small force F, and which produces extension dx. That work done will be given as work done is equal to force into displacement. Now force is small f, displacement will be the extension of the wire, that is dx, and therefore dw will be equal to f into dx. That will be equal to putting value of f yax upon l into dx will give us the work done dw. So this will be the small work done to produce the extension dx in that wire. But now suppose if we find out the total work done w to elongate or to stretch that wire from 0 to L, then it will be obtained by integrating this equation of dw. And therefore, that work done will be equal to integration from 0 to L dw. That is equal to integration 0 to L YAX upon L into dx. But YA upon L are constant factors, therefore they will be taken out of integration, and therefore we will get YA upon L integration 0 to L X dx. That will be written as, because this integration of X dx is equal to x square by 2, and therefore we will get YA upon L into x square by 2 from 0 to L. This L will be the upper limit of integration, 0 will be the lower limit. So putting these limits here, we can write W equal to YA upon L into L square by 2 minus 0 by 2, upper limit minus lower limit. This term will become 0, and therefore we will get half into YA L square upon L. YA L square upon L, that will be equal to half YA L upon L into L. This L square is splitted as L into L. But this term YA L upon L is nothing but the force F, and therefore we will get work done equal to half F into L. Half F into L, that is the total force F from equation 1. And therefore, that work done will be equal to half load into extension, because this F is nothing but load. And therefore, work done is equal to half load into extension, equation number 2. Now, the strain energy will be written as, the strain energy will be written as equal to work done, because this work done in that wire will be stored or will be gained by that wire in the form of strain energy. And therefore, strain energy will be equal to half load into extension, equation number 3. So in this way, the work done due to that stretching force in that wire will be stored in the form of strain energy, and therefore strain energy equal to half load into extension. So if we consider that wire of length capital L and area of cross section A, then it will be in the form of a cylinder, and therefore its volume will be A into L. That is, as volume of the wire is equal to AL. Therefore, from this we can find out strain energy per unit volume of that wire. That is, strain energy per unit volume will be equal to work done in stretching the wire. Work done in stretching the wire, that is total work done in stretching the wire, divided by volume of the wire. That is work done upon volume, and that will be written as half FL, that is the work done, it will be divided by AL. Separating the terms, we can write it as half into F by A into L upon L, F upon A into L upon L. That will be equal to F by A is nothing but the stress, and L by L is nothing but the strain, and therefore we can write that strain energy per unit volume equal to half stress into strain, half stress into strain, as equation number 4. Now, as Young's modulus Y is defined as, Young's modulus is defined as the longitudinal stress upon longitudinal strain, longitudinal stress upon longitudinal strain, and therefore we can write Young's modulus Y of that material of the wire equal to stress upon strain. Now from this formula, stress will be equal to Y into strain, that is stress equal to Y into strain, and strain will be equal to stress upon Y. Strain will be equal to stress upon Y. And therefore, by using these two formulae for stress and strain, we can write strain energy per unit volume. Strain energy per unit volume will be equal to half Y into strain square. Half Y into strain square. That is, in place of this stress, we can write Y into strain, and therefore we will get half Y into strain square. Similarly, if we replace the value of strain, that is stress upon Y, then we will get strain energy per unit volume of that wire will be equal to half stress square upon Y, half stress square upon Y. So this will represent the equation for strain energy per unit volume. And now let us see some of the terms related with this elastic nature of the wire, and that is hardness, strength, and toughness. So these are the three different properties possessed by the materials. Let us see the first one, that is hardness. So hardness is the property of the material which resists or opposes the plastic deformation of that body. Hardness is the property of material which opposes or resists the plastic deformation of that material. In other words, we can say that hardness is the stiffness or resistance to bend, scratch, or cut that material. So it is the resistance, or it is the opposition to bend or scratch or cut that material. So hard materials have little ductility. If the materials are hard, then their ductility will be less, and they are brittle also to some extent. Now, the greater is the hardness, then the greater will be the resistance for the deformation of that material. If hardness of the material is large or it is greater, then the resistance offered for the deformation of that body will be also large or greater. For example, if you consider the diamond, it is most hard material, and aluminium is less hard material. Now let us see second property, that is strength. The material is said to have more strength, that is the material will be said to be more strong, or its strength will be more if it requires higher force for its deformation. If it requires higher force for its deformation, for example, steel has high strength while plasticine clay have low strength. Now let us see third property, that is toughness. The ability of a material to resist fracturing when a force is applied to it is called as the toughness. The ability of a material to resist the fracturing when a force is applied to it is called as toughness. For example, plasticine clay are relatively tough since it can be scratched or it can be stretched and deformed due to the applied force without breaking. So in case of plasticine or clay, they are having relatively large toughness because it can be stretched or deformed due to applied force without breaking. And now if you consider any single material, then that single material will possess some of the properties like hardness, strength and toughness, and therefore we can say that a single material may be hard, tough and strong, that is its strength will be large. For example, if you consider the examples of it, then first example will be of bit of the drill machine. So drill bits must be hard, strong and tough. So all these properties will be possessed by the bit of the drill machine. Second example, if you consider the glass which will be hard and tough but not the strong, it will not be strong. That is, if you consider the bulletproof glass, particularly bulletproof glass, then it is hard and tough but it is not strong, that is its strength will be less. Its hardness and toughness will be large in case of the bulletproof glasses. So this will be regarding three different properties possessed by the materials, that is hardness, strength, that is strongness, and the toughness.